Hi, this is Stefan Ianev, Head of Research and Development for Clean Health. I've been in the fitness industry for over 20 years and educated over 5,000 personal trainers globally. In today's video, we're going to talk about the major dietary concerns with following a vegan diet. Now, I want to preface this video by saying that I'm not in any way against a vegan diet, and I actually believe there are certain advantages to at least on occasion following a vegan style diet. However, we also need to be aware of some of the concerns or the dietary concerns when it comes to following a vegan diet. Now, the first concern is getting adequate protein intake. Okay, and specifically getting adequate amount of complete proteins. So a complete protein is one that contains all the essential amino acids. Those are the amino acids that our body cannot synthesize on its own, and we need to obtain those from our diet. And specifically when it comes to body composition, it's only when we ingest full spectrum of amino acids, in other words, complete proteins, that we maximally trigger muscle protein synthesis. So if you're going to be following a vegan diet, you need to ensure that you're getting adequate protein and you're combining your food sources in a way that you're getting the full spectrum of amino acids in each and every meal, or at least in most of your meals. And this is where supplements like vegan-based or plant-based protein supplements can become very handy to make sure that you're meeting your protein requirements, or just educating yourself in which foods you need to combine, which plant-based or vegan-based foods you need to combine in order to get the full spectrum of essential amino acids. Now, the next nutrient that we need to be concerned about is saturated fat. Now, saturated fat specifically is a precursor to our steroid hormones. And studies have shown that diets low in fat lead to compromised androgen levels. And that can compromise your ability to A, build muscle mass, but also, if you're in a diet and your testosterone levels are tanking, you are at greater risk of muscle loss instead of losing fat. So we want to make sure, in order to preserve our androgen levels, that we're getting enough saturated fat. Now, since vegan diets are low in saturated fats, we need to look at other ways of obtaining saturated fat, such as coconut oil, for example. That's a nice, great source of saturated fat. The third thing we need to be concerned about is micronutrient deficiencies. So plant-based diets, for example, tend to be low in certain micronutrients like B12, iron, and zinc. So we typically tend to obtain those nutrients from eating a diet higher in animal proteins. So in the case of a vegan diet, when we're not consuming animal proteins, we want to make sure we're at least supplementing with those nutrients to make sure we're getting adequate amounts of those. And the last potential concern with following a vegan diet is the potential to overeat certain high calorie foods such as breads, sugars, and nuts. So even if we're following a vegan diet, it's important to still keep track of your portion sizes. If you like this video from Clean Health, make sure to click the like button and subscribe, share the video with your friends, and if you have any questions, please post your comments below.